Okay, so now that the infusion is complete, we could take a look at some of the numbers we have on our screen. As you can see on the right, we have 30.21 volume in milliliters infused. So our original was 30 milliliters set on the infusion device, so that's looking good. And on the left, you can see in the large numbers, we have 180.94 milliliters an hour, and our set rate on the infusion device was 180, so that's looking good. One other thing that I did do intentionally, I added an air bubble, just so you can see that the device does show if any air bubbles come through, which may mess up the measurement. Now looking at the beaker, you can see that it's very close to about 30 milliliters, which is right on point. If I go and I weigh this, and I weigh it on the scale here, this scale measures in grams. Now it needs to actually be zeroed out again because it's showing 112. It should be 114. There we go. And if I go and I weigh, due to the fact that this is distilled water at room temperature, you can see that it's showing 30 grams in weight. So we're right on the money with this. Oftentimes in hospitals, you'll find that a lot of clinical engineering teams will actually just use a scale to actually do their flow tests. So it's very important that you know how to do a measurement in grams to milliliters. And that's it, guys. That's all I have for the infusion device. Thank you.